All right.
Ready?
I am.
Okay, there we go. I actually started it again a little bit premature there, so I think they may have gotten you adjusting that table there or that
That's all
chair.
right. That's all
But
right.
anyways, we did this this impromptu little case study of sound this with a sound meter to see which chairs were the quietest and which chairs were the loudest because people want to relax in these chairs. And I believe at that time the Dreamwave or the Sonio at that time was one of the quietest chairs. So now you're telling me it's even quieter. So this is even contributing more to the soothing, relaxing experience in the chair.
That's right. And it's really the difference is really obvious when you have the two chairs side by side. I mean, I'm sure you've noticed it with the floor model that you have in your place there,
Yeah.
that it's
Yeah.
quite a bit quieter. I mentioned that we've increased the maximum air pressure of the arm massage units, but that is true for all the other air-driven massage aspects of the DreamWave as well.
Okay.
So the foot massage is significantly stronger. The sole massage air pressure is stronger. The calf massage air pressure is stronger. The seat massage air pressure is stronger. All of these things have increased in the DreamWave chair. And of course, if people don't want firm massage, all the adjustments are still available. You can actually reduce the air pressure if you want to do that. We have, there are some little things that we've changed too. The remote. I explained earlier that there's lots of information that the remote feeds you when you're using the chair. That scroll speed used to be painfully slow. I don't know if you
Yeah, I
remember
remember. I think the
that.
program started. I think, just wait a minute. Okay, yes, the program has started.
That's right.
I remember
So,
that.
I mean, it didn't change the quality of the massage of the chair. It was just a little tiny bit of a nuisance. And we've increased the speed of that scroll so that it's a little more convenient for consumers to use the chair.
Good.
We added a smartphone pocket to the chair.
Yeah, I've seen that.
You know from your experience in the massage chair market that lots of massage chairs have sound that is pre-installed in the chair, which requires a sound system. And inevitably, without naming any names, those sound systems tend to be not so good. Just,
Yeah, kind of
they're
cheap.
okay. It's like a they're inexpensive add-ons to other massage chairs that are in the marketplace. And we thought everybody on this planet has a pair of earbuds now or headphones like you're wearing at the moment. And everybody has a smartphone. Let's use those sound systems and let's continue to focus our energy and attention on massage itself
Right.
and provide people with a convenient place to place their smartphone, which is what we've done. So now you don't have to put it in your lap where it's going to slide off. If you want to listen to music, you just put in a pair of earbuds and experience the DreamWave with music that way.
Well, another thing is my experience with chairs, doing trade shows and whatnot, is that these chairs have a tendency to eat phones. And I've had a number of customers, not just on the United chair, but any chairs, but on any massage chairs, oftentimes, especially when they're fully reclined, those phones fall right out of the pockets and people don't even realize they're gone until later. So I guess
Yes.
it's a good way to keep track of your phone as well.
Yes. In our early years, when times were tight, that's how we were able to feed ourselves. We collected cell phones from people to check.
Yeah, right. Get those old dumb phones that worked for you.
That's right. We've made some other changes that are really going to be invisible to the consumer. There's a foot plate on the back of the foot massager that was structurally a slightly weak point. We would get occasional customer service calls to that piece had fallen off, and we would replace them. They're very easy to replace. But we've solved that problem now with a design change where that's just never going to that's never going to bother anybody ever again in the new DreamWave.
Good.
There's another silly little fun fact change that we made. The shipping strap on the old Sonia was just a black shipping strap. On the DreamWave, it says, I think the re it says remove before use or
Yeah.
remove before first flight or something.
Yeah.
Because what we were finding in our service people going into people's homes and what we were discovering when we were talking to customers at trade shows was that people were getting the chairs at home and they weren't removing the shipping strap.
Yeah.
And the chair is designed to be used without the shipping strap on. It creates all kinds of actually user issues, but I'm sure you noticed that too.
Yeah. Well, and just for people that are watching, the shipping strap is a black Velcro strap that you would wrap around the chair back, to hold the headpiece in place. And so people obviously weren't taking it off because it was under the plastic. So people may have assumed at that point that it was just part of the chair.
Right.
Yeah.
We have, there's some little tiny upholstery trim pieces that have been changed just to make the look a little bit different. The base color has changed a little bit.
Yeah.
There's another change that's going to be invisible to most consumers that actually matters to us. The way we see it, after a chair is sold, our job isn't even remotely close to being over. We want to support those customers throughout the warranty period and even beyond the warranty period. And you know, we're very proud of the products we put out there, and we want to make sure that customers, if they need to reach out to our service island, have a place that they can go where they can get answers.
And I, as a retailer, love hearing that, because that is, people get clouded, their judgment gets clouded by what they see or read or feel sitting in the chair. Very few people think beyond that to what's the customer support going to be like? What can I expect? What's the warranty like? A lot of people don't think about how important that customer service is if there's ever a problem down the road, and that is huge.
Well, I hope we've been good to you and to your customers.
Yep, very good.
Certainly a strategic focus for us. We believe it's part and parcel of the product.
Yep. You know,
it's not separate from what goes on in terms of massage capability.
Couldn't agree more.
Yeah. So what we've changed, again, what I'm saying that consumers won't see, is that the DreamWave has a lot of self-diagnosis functions. You can actually, through a variety of keystrokes on the remote, which our technicians know, our chair doctors know and understand, you can get information out of the chair about how it's performing, how a certain motor is performing, how much usage has been on the chair. And sometimes if there is some kind of fault in the chair, the remote will actually report it. As you dug down in those diagnostics, they used to be in Japanese. Mm-hmm. And so our support team actually got pretty good at figuring out technical error reporting in Japanese.
They're all bilingual now.
They can recognize the characters. They have no idea what they actually say, but they realize what problem they're sort of defining.
Sure.
But now those readouts are in plain English. So if we're sending a technician out to somebody in the field and we need to do diagnosis, we don't have to have a technician who doesn't understand what those readouts mean sort of take a picture of it on their iPhone, send it to us, and all that stuff. That's cleaned it up, and it makes service go a little more smoothly for the consumer. I think we've hit, you know, I think those are the big changes between the two chairs.
How long did it take from start to finish, from concept to actual, you know, delivery? Did it take to come up with the new DreamWave?
First Sonio took about 7 years, right, from concept to delivery. The DreamWave changes we talked about for over a year. And really most of these changes were driven by what retailers were telling us, what consumers were telling us,
right,
what we were experiencing ourselves at trade shows in terms of things that would be would represent a valuable upgrade to end users in moving from the Sonio to the DreamWave.
So it was about a year in
a year, say a year and a planning quarter, and 3 months, give or take.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Well, I've got the new DreamWave in my showroom. Right away, we got it in the showroom, and I love it. I really do like it. And of course, the experience when people come to the showroom is, you know, they sit on a lot of the chairs. Some of them are afraid to sit on the DreamWave because they don't want to spend that money, or it's not in their budget. But almost 100% of the time when they sit in the DreamWave, they can recognize almost immediately the difference in this sophistry of the roller technology. And so people, and I think some of that has to do with your sophisticated scanning protocols, which I think are a little bit more elaborate than maybe a lot of the Chinese made chairs, which I think are mostly just measuring where the head and the shoulders are to get an idea of the height, so the rollers don't go and hit the head and don't go too low on the neck. But on yours, it seems to be a pretty sophisticated body scan. But when you combine that with the level of technology that you've developed over 50 years of doing this business, working this business, you get a massage that is noticeably different to most people that sit in it. Any comments about that, or anything you want to speak to that at all?
I think you've just said it pretty well. First of all, with respect to scanning, there's a buyer beware element in the marketplace in terms of scanning technology. And what I mean by that is every massage chair maker, large or small, well-known brand, unknown brand, wants to make the claim that their massage chair offers body scanning. It has been my experience in looking at lots and lots of chairs in the marketplace that some of those chairs actually do offer body scanning, and other chairs don't offer any kind of body scanning, even though they may claim to offer body scanning. And then there's some chairs in the middle that have some kind of body scanning technology, but as you noted just a little bit earlier, that technology isn't necessarily accurate or productive from the actual user experience perspective. Understanding body scan really has to be a personal experience. Somebody showing up at your showroom will understand a chair that has great body scanning versus a chair that doesn't have great body scanning. You're right. Inada was the first company to market with body scanning technology. Happened in 1999. The Dreamwave incorporates a evolved sort of iteration of that same scanning technology that existed in 1999. And with the advent of scanning technology from the Inada company, other manufacturers begin to either install it or start to make the claim that their chairs had the scanning technology. And today, really, you can't sell a premium chair in the marketplace without at least claiming that you have body scanning technology. Otherwise, you're just not playing in that space.
Right.
Those claims and reality, there can be a very, very wide gulf between those two things. So consumers really do need to be careful. We're the pioneer. Our body scanning technology, as you noted, is excellent. It does actually manage and affect the massage. It does keep people from getting clobbered in the head, which is nice.
Yeah.
And
but it's also in other subtle ways. Like a lot of times, some people feel, and I've heard people describe this, when they're on some other chair, sometimes they know the roller's coming, and it's coming to their mid back, and they know it's going to be a little uncomfortable, so they kind of brace themselves for it. One of the pieces of feedback I got on the Dreamwave was that when the chair, and maybe this is for all the chairs, come to think of it, all the United chairs, but when the rollers are moving up and down the spine, people are not having to guard themselves for fear of, oh, this it's going to come and hit that spot again. And I think that might, again, speak to the sophistication of the body scan. Maybe it's able to read the shape of the spine better, and it just knows, okay, coming to the mid-back, ease up a little bit, or this guy's going to be, bracing himself. So it does seem to have some pretty, I don't know, more profound effects on the comfort for the customer, as opposed to just, fitting them.
I guess the way I would answer that question is that building a massage chair that provides an effective massage, keeps people from bracing themselves because they're fearful that it's going to hit them on a bony prominence or be uncomfortable at a particular place on their back, involve this sort of sophistry that you describe, really drive somebody's level of relaxation into a wonderful, wonderful place. For all of those things to work together, all of a sudden you're starting to drift away from a feature set. This chair has this chair has that, this chair has this. And you start talking about a feeling or a sensation or an overall organic experience. And in that way, and it's so many different little things. You're beginning to just touch on them. It's so many different little things. In that way, Inada separates itself. We separate ourselves from the rest of the crowd because all of those little things are considered. Could Inada build a massage chair that basically just, really beat the crap out of you? Of course. It's not hard. It's not hard to do that. Not hard for Inada to do that. But providing an effective, comfortable, wonderful user experience that is worth the thousands and thousands of dollars that it takes to get into a knotted chair involves a lot more than just making it strong.
Right.
Making it good takes a lot more time and effort and care than just making it strong.
Yeah, and I think, and that's what people know Inada for, is a phenomenal massage experience. I might just add, though, that one of the knocks I've heard in the years gone by is that the Dreamwave or the previous Sonia was too gentle, and that kind of bothered me for some reason. It was almost like it was a slam against the chair. So I took another a typical Chinese chair that kind of copied its body styling to the Dreamwave. And it was a chair that had 3D roller technology like the Dreamwave has. And I compared the intensity of the rollers, because this other chair is a Chinese chair and is known for being a more vigorous massage. And I actually compared this is subjective. It's based on my own experience sitting in the chair. But I found that when I turned the intensity, and this is in my article library, my blog, you can go read this article. It's comparing the Dreamwave to the Dreamer. Plus the names are very similar. And I found, and I did this basically to either support or refute these claims that the DreamWave was too gentle. And so I cranked it up all the way. I took all the padding off of both, increased the intensity on both, and I found that the neck and upper back massage was more intense on the DreamWave. And as a matter of fact, I can still remember sitting in the chair going, oh, like I could make it that intense. But I also found that the other chair did not have the same neck and upper back intensity. I found that the low back intensities were comparable, but I immediately realized that anybody that has said that the DreamWave is too gentle of a massage has not really either been coached well in it to use it, or just didn't even know that there was an ability to increase the intensity or to manipulate the intensity. And the chair can be very intense if that's what you want. So I kind of like that about the DreamWave. It's not a soft wussy chair. It's got all the guts you need if you want some intensity.
Right, and I do think that we hear that on occasion from consumers who have bought the chair. We hear that from our dealers on the sales floor who are confused and unsure about how to make the DreamWave an intense massage chair. We have no doubt that if intensity is what people want, the product provides it.
Yeah,
but some of what adds to the magic of DreamWave is that it cannot be intense if it's not intensity that you want. Mm-hmm. If you take, again, without naming names, some of the more aggressive chairs, mm-hmm. and you ask that chair to provide you with a gentle massage, you're out of luck.
Can't do it.
You can't do it.
No.
Whereas with a DreamWave chair, if mm-hmm. your wife is 6 months pregnant, and all she wants is a really, really gentle massage,
right,
it can do it.
It can do it.
And then if you want to hop in the chair and get cranked on, it can do that
too. It can do that as well.
So yeah. That broad range is part of what makes DreamWave special as well.
Yeah, I couldn't agree more. I actually, and not to plug my own content, but I have a video that talks about how to adjust the intensity of the DreamWave. There's multiple ways. It's not just using the 3D. You know, there's positioning, there's taking off the back pad. And I've talked about that in that video because that is a question that I get asked a lot. And so there is a video that talks about how to get the intensity of that chair more intense. Okay, now we've talked about the DreamWave. What I want to do now is talk a little bit about the Flex 3S, which is kind of a, when you first look at it, and I've got them side by side in my showroom, it looks like a mini me is what the Flex looks like, but it's not at all like the DreamWave. The way it feels, the way it massages, it's a whole different experience. Maybe you can talk to speak to that chair, to some of the details about that chair and the big picture.
Yes, let me start with the big picture because that's. You know, there's a reason why Flex exists, why Flex 3S exists, and I'll try and sort of summarize that for anybody that's watching. DreamWave is a thorough, encompassing, total escape kind of massage. If you want a little mini vacation for 15 minutes a day where the rest of your world simply disappears on you, the DreamWave is a very, very good solution for that. The Flex 3S exists as a posture correcting chair, as a chair that addresses the way you sit and stand throughout your day, and when you use it, provides movements, biomechanical movements that help improve your posture, either through reminding you how to keep your shoulders back and your chin in and stand up straight because of its motions, or through actually regular use, perhaps even improving the mobility of your spine over time when you use it regularly. You've used the Flex, you know that some of those back mobilization movements, these kinds of movements, can be quite intense if you want them to be in the
right.
Flex. And that makes it very, very different than the DreamWave. Does the Flex give you a great overall body massage? Absolutely. There are program sessions in the Flex that are superb massage sessions. But what's its calling card? What's its real primary reason to exist? I would say it's to improve your posture. And we care about posture, and we talk about posture, and advocate for good posture because posture is personality.
Right.
How you stand, how you present yourself, tells other people a lot about how you're feeling inside. It changes the way you personally feel inside. And, you know, aside from all the very healthy reasons to maintain good posture, as we age, good posture is important. As we age, good posture is important for functional movements and things like that. There's also this other benefit, which is that if you're standing up straight, sitting up straight, and that's how you walk into a room and that's how you carry yourself, it changes your own outlook on your own self. It affects your mind. Your body affects your mind. And the flex is a great tool to teach you about good posture, to help you maintain good posture. And if you have lousy posture, or if you work at a computer all day long, it's a great sort of corrective measure, if you will. A therapy that you can engage in for 15 minutes a day that can address some of those very unhealthy postures that you may maintain for the rest of the day.
Right.
That's flex, sort of the highest level in a nutshell.